Billy has achieved true sight. Or at least that's one interpretation.
Mr. Jones?
Mr. Jones?
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm sorry. What was I saying?
Okay, you ready?
I'm ready. Wow, I was so not ready.
Yeah, what do you think?
I think you've come a long way from when you were 8 and said you wanted to be a firefighter.
We're having the baby.
With me. I'm having our baby.
We're planning on raising this child together, just the three of us.
As one big, happy, non-traditional family.
What in the actual?
And they call me Cherry Bombshell.
Cheryl? Good. I actually wanted to talk to you about stepping back from the Vixens.
Tell me.
You have to keep it a secret though, okay?
Oh God. Please don't tell me you and Jughead are getting back together.
No! It's me and Archie. We've been doing this casual friends with benefits thing.
Shut the front door.
Katie Keene? How are you, girl?
Oh my God, girl, I am reeling. So I'm having lunch with Francois and
Juniper Dagwood. This artwork is so beautiful. Your mom's gonna love this when she gets home.
Your sister, she called. She's alive.
What? When? Are you sure it was Polly?
Yes, of course I'm sure. I know the sound of my own daughter's voice.
What did she say? Walk me through everything.
Okay, the phone rang, the landline. I picked up and it was Polly. She was hysterical. She was talking a mile a minute. I tried to keep her on the phone, but she was scared.
Mom, are you sure it wasn't just some crank?
Yes, she was scared. She couldn't see anything. She was being kept somewhere. It was dark. Everything was cold and smooth, like metal. Quite frankly, it sounded like a spaceship.
Were you missing time, too?
Yeah, I mean, I probably just fell asleep.
Blackouts are fairly common during supposed encounters with extraterrestrials. Have you ever blacked out before?
This was a mistake. Sorry.
Wow, you boys made some real progress. Well done. Oh, you know what we should do? Document our reno journey. Let me get between you two.
But first, let me take a selfie.
Perfection. Now flex for my followers.
Cheryl, what's this all about? I wanted to apologize for being so cuckoo to you earlier. You let me have a do-over.
Of course, Cheryl. You know your support means the world to me.
The impending crush of true adulthood. Our 30s. And soon after, mortality. The big sleep.
Cheryl, you've got to be kidding me. I'm not bringing my baby into this house of horrors.
The last 2 months, all you've been trying to do is draw me out of Thornhill.
Yeah, and as my reward, you're trying to trap me here like you did at Thistle House with your 2 dead brothers? Well, it's not going to work. I'm done trying to bring you down from the mountain. I'm done trying to have a normal friendship with you. That was my mistake. I should have just left our relationship where it belongs. In the past. Like, I'm sorry I led you on, and I'm sorry I agreed to this stupid party. Really, really am.
I'm repulsive.
No.
Cheryl, you're gorgeous.